Today, I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily match color in Photoshop. Hey guys, and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. This is Rabi from RetutStudio.com, and in this video, I'm going to give you two different techniques that will help you match color fast in Photoshop. So here we are in Photoshop, and we have two images that we need to match their color together. And you can see that our background is warm, and our subject has a cool contrast, and we need to match the color. In this case, we want to match the subject to the background. So what I'm going to do is create a curves adjustment layer on top of our subject. Then I'm going to hold Alt or Option and click between the two layers to create a clipping mask. You can also create a clipping mask by clicking on this icon in the Properties panel. And what this does is the curves adjustment layer is now only affecting our subject and not our background. I'm going to click on this icon to reset curves. And now what we need to do is click on this menu and then select auto options. This will bring us the auto options dialog box. And the auto options has four different algorithms that we can use to auto correct our images. If I select find dark and light colors and then click on the shadows and then sample a color from the shadows in our image, you can see that it sampled a white color. Why is that? That's because our layer mask is selected. So make sure that the layer itself is selected. You can see now it's highlighted when I clicked on it. And now we can do that again and select auto options. And now I'm going to choose enhance per channel contrast. I'm going to click on shadows and then sample a color from the shadows in our background. You can see that Photoshop automatically applied that color to the shadows of our subject. I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to click on highlights and then sample a color from the highlights area in our image. In this case, I'm going to select this bright orange color near the sun. And now that color is applied to the highlights in our subject. Click OK and then click OK again. And now Photoshop will ask you if you want to make this color as the default highlight and shadows colors for curves. In this case, we don't want that. We only want to apply this color once. So I'm going to click no. And now as you can see, our subject is matching the background. That looks a lot better than before. But if the adjustment layer for you was not looking the way you wanted, you can always go back to the auto correction options by holding Alt or Option and clicking on the auto button. And you can go back and edit the colors to your liking. And if it's still not matching and doesn't look right, it's probably a luminosity problem. So if that is the case, I'm going to show you how to fix that. So to figure out if it's a luminosity problem, we need to see the image in black and white by creating a check layer. And it could be as simple as creating a black and white adjustment layer. Or we can create a solid color and then choose a neutral color. It doesn't matter white, black, or 50% gray. You want to make sure it's neutral, and you can tell by looking at the hue and saturation values over here, and you can see that both of them are zero, and they stay at zero even when I'm moving the color picker up and down. But when I move it to the right, you can see that the saturation value has changed. So make sure that it's neutral and then click OK. And now what you need to do is change the blending mode to color, and that will convert our image to black and white. And this is actually more accurate than a normal black and white adjustment layer. You can see when I turn it on and off, there is no change, but if I turn the black and white adjustment layer on and off, it is affecting the luminosity values. But we can still make the black and white adjustment layer more accurate by changing its blending mode to color, and now it's only affecting color. This is just another way of doing it, and I want you to know different methods if you want to be more accurate when you are making your adjustments. So now that we have eliminated color from our image that was distracting us before, and now we can only look at it in black and white. And now we can ask ourselves, is the subject matching the background or not? And in this case, I can see that the subject is a little bit brighter than the background. So I'm going to add a curves adjustment layer. Then create a clipping mask, and I'm going to make the subject a little bit darker. And by doing that, you can see that it's looking much better now and it's matching the background. Here's the before and after. Now this curves adjustment layer is also affecting color, but when I change the blending mode to luminosity, now it's only affecting luminance. Also, I'm going to change the blending mode of the color balance to color as well. And now it's only affecting color. And now you can change color and luminosity accordingly. And this is a great technique if you want to work on your color and luminosity separately. Again, this is before and this is the after. So that's one way to match color quickly and easily. I'm going to show you now a different technique using color check layers. So first of all, I'm going to delete the color adjustment layer and I'm going to leave the luminosity adjustment layer, and now we can only focus on color. So to create a color check layer, we are going to need to create another solid color, and you need to drag the color picker to the top right corner so that the saturation and the brightness is at 100%. It doesn't matter if you change the hue slider or not for now. Click OK and now change the blending mode to luminosity. And this will leave us with only a color map of our image, and this will help us match the color of our subject to the background. So if your image is a little bit desaturated, you can add a hue saturation adjustment layer and crank up the saturation, and that will help us see the image a little bit better. You can also go back and change the hue value from the solid color to help you see the color map a little bit better. I'm going to stick with the blue and click OK. So now let's add a color balance adjustment layer this time and clip it to our subject. And now looking at the image, we can clearly see that the subject is not matching the background and has a blue color contrast. So the first thing I'm going to do is reduce the blues and add yellows. We can also add a little bit of greens and reds. And you can see now how the subject is starting to match with the background. Now let's go to shadows and add a little bit of yellow to the shadows and a little bit of greens as well, and I'm gonna add more reds. Now in the highlights, let's do the same thing. This time I'm not going to make extreme changes. And now as you can see, this is the before and the after. Now the color in the subject matches the background. And if I turn off all these check layers, here's how it looks like. We can also change the blending mode to color as well, so it's only affecting color. Again, let me show you the before and after of everything. This is the before, and this is the after. Alright, that's it. These are the two techniques that I wanted to show you today. These techniques will help you quickly match color between two images, especially if you're not sure where to start to match color. So if you have found this tutorial helpful, please subscribe to this channel and also turn on the notification bell so you don't miss a new tutorial each time I upload it. Also, check out the link in the description to visit the detailed article and download the source images. So that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.